the truth about Tennessee's housing market. Will prices fall? Over the last 2 years, the Tennessee housing market has been on absolute fire. But what can we expect in 2023? Are prices going to fall now that interest rates have taken off? I've been a real estate agent since 2007, right at the start of the big market crash, and I've seen both the good and the bad in my career. However, nothing compares to the extreme seller's market we've been in over the last couple of years. Prices took off with no end in sight. Homes were going under contract the first day or two on the market, and multiple offers drove prices up to new highs almost every month. I'd heard of real estate markets like this in the past from agents that worked in California and Arizona, for example, but never could I have imagined that we'd see 10 offers on homes regularly in Northeast Tennessee. This area would have market ups and downs, of course, but things were less extreme. We didn't have the big gains, but by the same token, we didn't lose huge chunks of value when the market was down. But this latest seller's market hit our area just like the rest of the country. It had become norm in our area to see 20% gains annually in home values, which is just unheard of here. But what's going on now that the market has shifted? Since we had those big gains, are we also set up for some big losses? Depending on whether you look online or on the nightly news, you're going to find people preaching doom and gloom. The market is crashing just like 2008. Then on the other side, some seemingly always positive real estate agents and mortgage lenders are telling you, well, it's not that bad and things could be so much worse. You've heard people tell you how interest rates were much higher when they bought, and historically rates are still a good value. Like that's supposed to help you feel better about the rate more than doubling in a year. Let's forget about all those national numbers and reports from the major housing markets, and let's talk about what's going on in our corner of Northeast Tennessee by looking at the hard numbers here, and we'll share with you what we see as agent with boots on the ground daily. Many of you may have seen the video we posted in June of this year, 2022, giving you our opinion of what inflation, interest rate increases, and home value appreciation were going to do to the market. At the time, interest rates were just under 6%, and now they're trending above 7%. And I was talking about the market shift that was imminent. Well, that shift is here, and the market is showing signs of slowdown in sales for sure. The problem for home buyers, though, is that the market is slow to balance out since there are still not enough homes available to meet the demand. As of the end of October, pending sales in our area fell for the sixth straight month. And versus the same time last year, pending sales were down over 28%. Well, with pending sales down, it sounds like sellers are going to have to expect less for their homes and we should see depreciation, right? Well, not so fast. Even though sales have fallen, the amount of available inventory hasn't changed all that much. To give you some idea of where the local market stands in regards to inventory, I'll start with a couple of figures. Now stay with me here. I'm not going to throw 50 numbers at you and quiz you at the end, but I was an engineer in the past and I do like, at least briefly, going over the data. A term the real estate industry uses to judge what type of market we're in as far as whether it's a seller's, a buyer's, or a balanced market is called month supply. A 6 month supply of homes is considered a balanced market, for example. Much over that, and it's a buyer's market. Much under 6 months, and you're looking at a seller's market. For 23 straight months, we've had less than 2 months of inventory, a very strong seller's market. In fact, it's been over 4 years in early 2018 since the area has seen a balanced market. At the end of October 2022, we had 1.7 months of inventory. And until there's a significant increase of inventory in relation to sales, our prices just won't fall. Now, a couple of signs that the market is changing a bit since sales started slowing are the days on market and the number of multiple offers. It is taking a bit longer to sell than it was this past spring, and you don't run into near as many multiple offer situations. Seller can't just put any price on their home and rely on that fear of missing out and multiple offers to get them their price. Homes need to be ready to sell and price near market price, not above. One problem right now is that not all sellers have gotten the message about the market shift, and many are still pricing their homes like it's 2021. I think some of the agents haven't shifted their mindset yet either. In fact, a lot of agents that jumped into the business over the past 2 or 3 years are getting their first taste of a shifting market and are still learning how to react. People are playing catch up, which happens every time the market shifts. Another sign of the slowdown that we're seeing is how much easier it is to get a showing appointment. In the spring, you were lucky to be able to get a showing appointment on some new listings without waiting a day or two. Other agents would have all the time slots filled, and if you didn't jump on it, we'd have to wait. Sometimes the house would have a contract before we could even get in to see it. Now, most of the time, scheduling a showing is easy, and you can pick pretty much any time slot you need. Since the majority of our business is helping buyers from out of state, the last 2 to 3 years hasn't been easy at times. Working with buyers in the seller's market is tough. There's no telling how many offers our buyers lost over the past couple of years due to multiple offers and those competing buyers who'd pay nearly anything to secure a home. Sometimes it would take months to find the right house and get it under contract. Working with sellers required so much less energy. Put it on the market at a reasonable price with good pictures and a great description, and you could almost count on multiple offers. So personally, I'm glad things are beginning to turn around a bit, even if it's slow to get there. I've never thought that the fear of missing out was a good motivator when making decisions on which house to buy and how much to pay for it. It should be a thoughtful process based on your needs and wants, not desperation. I've worked totally balanced markets and strong buyers markets where prices were falling almost daily and the buyers had all the control. My personal preference is a more balanced market. We were in just such an extreme buyers market that the little bit of breathing room we now have feels like a huge shift. In reality, we're still in a strong seller's market and prices are still rising overall, just at a much slower and more realistic rate. One thing that's keeping our market from flipping into a more balanced market is the demand from out-of-state buyers. One estimate puts the number of new out-of-state residents coming to Johnson City at 3 every day. So roughly 90 new people are moving to Johnson City from other parts of the country every month. And that's just Johnson City, not the other cities in the area. Transplants are helping to offset the loss of buyers that can't buy due to interest rate increases and appreciation. At first, people looking to Tennessee for the low cost of living and lack of income tax were coming to Middle Tennessee. But as demand skyrocketed, so did prices. So Middle Tennessee isn't the value it once was. So some people have shifted their gaze towards East Tennessee. Our area's cost of living remains very low compared to much of the country, and that's helping to support the housing demand in Northeast Tennessee. One side effect of higher prices, however, is that current homeowners who have been here for years aren't as likely to sell. Where would they go? Sure, they have a lot of equity in their homes at this point, but why sell and move unless they can find a part of the country with an even lower cost of living that they would enjoy just as much? So the effect is compounding the problem. Higher interest rates not only slow down buyers, but cause sellers to think twice about listing their home. If they have a mortgage on the existing home at 3%, why sell, take the equity, and then have to borrow at 7%? You can understand. So what does the future hold for our market? If interest rates keep increasing, sales decrease further, and a true recession takes hold in our area, there's the possibility of a market adjustment. Worst case, it's possible that over the next 12 to 18 months, we could see appreciation stop if things got bad enough. And no one knows the future, of course. But I can tell you one thing as an experienced agent who went through the crash in 2008 to 2010, we will not see a return to those times. I won't go into the details of why there's not going to be a crash, but times are very different. Banks would loan money to people that had no business buying homes for the amount they qualified for, and owners had very little, if any, equity in their property, and foreclosures were a large part of the market. Lending standards are now much higher, and the amount of equity in most homes would keep most foreclosures from ever happening. If there's enough equity in your home, no reason to quit paying. You could just sell and at least not lose the equity you've built up. Just to give you local foreclosure numbers, there are currently 28 active foreclosure listings in the entire MLS, and that's out of 1,230 active listings. So that's just over 2% of everything listed for sale, which is a very low number. Now, we'll keep our eyes on this and look for any trends and be sure to let you know if we see anything troubling. Here's what I think is most likely to happen locally. Over the next year, price appreciation will continue, but at a much slower rate, maybe 2 to 3% or so. Those years of 20% appreciation are over, as they should be. It was a matter of time. Sales will slow and inventory will slowly rise. However, our area will continue to see out-of-state buyers moving here, and that insulates our local market from the harsh downturns that are already happening in other parts of the country. I saw an article the other day by Lawrence Jung, the chief economist from the National Association of Realtors. He was talking about that in 2023, it was going to be a rough year in the real estate market, with price appreciation nationally expected to be just 1%. This isn't a crash, a big adjustment to what we've seen nationally, perhaps, but not a crash. I don't think that demand long-term is going to fall. The appeal of the beauty of our area simply isn't going to change. Word has gotten out, and as long as our cost of living remains lower than much of the country, we'll continue our steady growth. So that's my take on things. Please do me a favor. If you enjoyed this content, hit the like and subscribe buttons. YouTube will help push our content out to more people if you do, and we'll be very grateful. Thank you so much for watching. If we can help, just let us know. This is Scott Henninger with the Home Team, brokered by eXp Realty, where we're exceeding expectations, whether it's your first home or your last.